What's going on, YouTube? This is SG1 Sports, and you're watching our ACC football channel. A very disappointing finish to the 2019 season for the Miami Hurricanes. The schedule really wasn't that bad in 2019. They played through the ACC, which of course is down. Winnable games really in every conference game, and they still finished a 6-6 in the regular season. They didn't have to play Clemson. They did play Florida in the non-conference, so they did have a big non-conference matchup, and they've done a nice job scheduling, you know, these big non-conference games. They played LSU a couple of years ago as well, so I like that. I like to see that, especially from an ACC team that has four non-conference games, and like I said, just they play in the ACC. But the big thing for anybody's schedule in this conference is avoiding Clemson, obviously. Well, let's take a look at the 2020 schedule. They do avoid Clemson once again, and they don't have a real tough non-conference matchup either. At the time, we thought the Michigan State game would be a big game, but now Michigan State probably not going to be anywhere near the top 25. But they open up with Temple on September the 5th. This is a tricky game. Temple is not a bad team. Miami, are they going to get it turned around? You know, with De'Arik King at quarterback, assuming he's the starter, with the defense, it's always good. It's about that offense, and if they can get things going offensively, this should be a really good team. But if they don't, you could struggle against a team like Temple. I know Miami fans are probably going to say, we'll beat Temple. Temple's the easy win. Well, this is a team that just got shut out and lost to Louisiana Tech 14-0 in their bowl game last year. So I don't think you can assume any wins, but they are the better team here. Temple, not a bad group of five team. Miami, the better team. And then Wagner, that should be an easy win on September the 12th. UAB on September 17th. UAB, another game that Miami you would expect to win. And then there's that big non-conference game on September 26th at Michigan State. Michigan State, again, I think it's going to be down this year. Lost their head coach, lost their starting quarterback. The defense lost a ton of production. So you like Miami's chances to start the season off 4-0 with this schedule before getting into ACC conference play. And again, they don't play Clemson. They don't play Notre Dame. I know Notre Dame's not actually in the ACC, but you do have a rotation with Notre Dame if you're in this conference. So they avoid that. And that makes the schedule really, really soft. I mean, this is one of the easier schedules, and maybe with this schedule, they can do better than 6-6 this year. I think you would expect them to, especially Miami fans, I think are expecting a lot more than 6-6. We'll see what happens. Pittsburgh on October the 3rd, games at home, not an easy win, but it should be a good game. Pretty evenly matched teams, I think, in that one. Wake Forest on October the 9th on the road. Could be a tough matchup. North Carolina, I think, one of the better teams in the Coastal Division this year on October 24th. That could be a game that decides the division. I know there are other teams, Virginia Tech, Pitt, you know, Virginia, obviously. You've got other teams that are going to have a shot in this division, but that could be a game that decides it at the end of the day. I think it really could. That is a big game, and the good news for Miami is that they get that game at home. Virginia is on the road on October 31st. Cavaliers are going to be looking for some revenge. After they lost on the road last year, that'll be a big game in the division as well. Florida State comes on November the 7th. Seems like they used to always play kind of early in the year. They're playing pretty late this year in the month of November. Home game for Miami. Florida State's a team that we don't know what to expect exactly from. That could be a really good game. I know you're probably going to think this is crazy, but I could see both of those teams being ranked at that point. I know we haven't really seen that in this matchup, this rivalry. But I think both teams have a chance to really get it turned around this year. And it could be one of the bigger games of the season. I know right now you kind of laugh and say, nobody's going to care about that game besides Miami and Florida State fans. But it could have some impact there. I think, again, both teams could potentially be ranked if they play up to their potential. Both of these teams have really struggled on the offensive line. I think that's the area people kind of don't realize. If both teams get better there, I think they really do turn things around. So that'll be a big game, of course, on November 7th. Always a big game for Miami and Florida State. Virginia Tech on November 14th. Another huge game in the division. Talked about that North Carolina game being a game that could decide it. This game could be a game that decides it. Bad news this time. So, again, I think Pitt and Virginia are in the conversation. But I still, just my gut is telling me, and I haven't evaluated all the teams yet, my gut's telling me that North Carolina, Miami, and Virginia Tech are going to be the three teams that play here. So Miami is going to play one at home and one on the road. And I think that actually works out for all three of those teams. So it's going to be an even playing field. No team really with a big advantage getting, you know, some big games at home or more big games at home. North Carolina, Virginia Tech, I think the two biggest games in the division for Miami. Georgia Tech is on the road on November 21st. And then it's Duke at home on November 28th. Don't know for sure what we're going to see from Duke. It could be a pretty interesting team there as well. So a lot of games that Miami, or a lot of games that are probably going to be close. They're going to have probably a lot of close games in the ACC this season. And if they can win those close games, they're probably going to have a great year, have a shot to win the division. If they lose some close games, it's probably going to go the other way. I really feel like it's a fine line for Miami. But the schedule puts them in a position to where they could potentially have a really, really good year. Could potentially win 9 or 10 games with this schedule. Wouldn't surprise me at all. But at the same time, I could see them going 6-6 as well, just because there are going to be so many close games. It's just kind of my early thoughts on it. Obviously, Miami could surprise and be a lot better than they were last year. Or maybe they'll be about the same. And if they're about the same again, I think it'll come down to a lot of those close games in 2020 for this Miami team.